Is it weird to relate the toys to Justin Bieber?
When you think of like male pop stars, like the first one I think of is like Justin Bieber.
I think a lot of these artists that are really popular in Thailand are probably artists that would be popular internationally.
I don't think he would be popular in the United States. Sawadika!
There are a few Thai artists and bands that I keep up with, but the one that I'm most interested in is Slot Machine.
Yeah, I don't really listen to that much Thai music. I know Slot Machine. Scott's done covers of like Thai songs before, and I've heard like those songs, but that's about it for like Thai music.
Whoa! Okay, this video is going to be a reaction to Thai musicians that you guys probably are very familiar with if you're from Thailand. Thai musicians I am not at all familiar with because I am not from Thailand. I am familiar with one of the artists that we're going to get to today, but not familiar enough. So it will be a pretty genuine reaction to some of what I'm going to hear today. And I'm looking forward to it. Before we get into the video, be sure to like, be sure to comment, be sure to subscribe, do all the things, and hope you enjoy.
Ooh, she's pretty. I like her earrings. Oh, I like her hoodie. I didn't expect this to be in English.
I love the cinematography. She has a nice voice. You and me when nobody's around. These are great lyrics. I don't know if she writes her own lyrics, but these are awesome. Every second when we
broke up in your car, I like the angles of this video. Yeah, I'll do it again.
Well, that's sad.
Closing thoughts.
I liked it. Aw, is it over? Yeah, it's ended.
Okay, cool. I liked her. She had a great voice.
Yeah, I liked it.
I don't know if she's the one writing her lyrics, but they're great lyrics too. So all around, I think it's a cool sound. I can understand how people would relate to it.
I can imagine a lot of people vibing to that, especially, I was going to say summertime, but like it's always hot there.
I'd be surprised if she isn't already popular in the USA. I don't know her demographic, but yeah, she's. I can see her being popular here.
Oh, she's so cute. You treat your
mom. I love her look. Things that I gotta know. How many pesos do you believe? I love this like mix of sort of vintagey styles and modern styles. It's a cool vibe. You know, it's awesome too because it's like so many people try to go for the vintage vibe where they do these, I don't know what you call it, a letterbox or something like that. That sort of like vintagey film cutout thing. So many people do that, but they do it in a way that seems like they're trying to make it look like an authentic film recording or something.
Oh, she looks so cute. I really like all her outfits. Oh, I like that outfit a lot. I like her jeans.
But yeah, she's mixing sort of like that authentic approach with this modernized version of it, where it's like she has that sort of letterbox look, but then she has like the layered backdrop of the same video. These aspect ratios all over the place. Some of it fills my whole screen. Some of it's like got the widescreen black bars. Some of it's squared off. This is crazy. And for whatever reason, this person cannot get into her phone.
Oh, I like the pigtails. I like all her outfits a lot. Oh, the girls are so pretty.
Oh, this video is so cool. All the like text animation, the color grade. I mean, I should comment on the music, right? the song is great. She's super cool. I like this. Oh my god! Was that like a GoPro angle and then like a transition into... I don't even know what that is with the yellow thing behind her. This video is so awesome.
Aw.
What an awesome video. That was super cool.
Yeah, I liked that song a lot. It was really poppy and it was cool. Like, it was a fun song.
I loved her. I don't know if all of her videos are like that or all of her content is like that, but at least for the branding on this particular song and video, it was a really cool approach of modernizing those types of vintage aesthetics and nostalgic medias, I guess.
I liked the music video too a lot when she was in the arcade in the carriage scene. That was fun. And like when she was like at the skate park, that was cool. That was fun. That was cool. I really liked the, when she was laying on the ground and there was like a bunch of cell phones around her. That was awesome. Cool, fun, and awesome.
I think a lot of these artists that are really popular in Thailand are probably artists that would be popular internationally because they just have a really accessible and likable look and feel with just their music and their videos and everything.
She was like a really fun artist. That was a fun song. I don't know about her other songs, but that song was fun. They're really like cute. I'm not gonna sing. It all sounds like pop music.
She's so fun, she's so cool, and then just, it all sounds the same.
What the duck?
The Toys always has such interesting production.
Oh, do I know this song? Oh, I know this song. I've seen this music video already.
There are such like interesting sounds in all of his songs. I think the unique production really lends itself to his success because there aren't a lot of people with music that have this sound. And then obviously he's got a nice voice and everything, so that helps.
Now she had too much to drink. No, oh, this is sad. No. Oh. Oh. Is that an ex or something? Oh, she's so sad. That was sad. I've seen this music video before, though.
Old news.
Old news.
I like the Toys a lot. I think his production is always really unique and interesting. Just the sounds that they use in the music and everything are always super just unheard of. I love the production of his songs.
Yeah, everyone loves the sad pop song. He does have like a unique sound though. Like he's kind of like rockish. I don't know. He's cool. He's just cool. I like him.
And I think his voice really sits within that unique production style really well.
No, the Toys is cool.
Is he fun?
He's fun. He's cool. Awesome? He's a little sad. He's awesome. Making me cry. I don't know the song. He's really cool. He's a cool guy. Is it weird to relate the Toys to Justin Bieber?
I love his production. I love everything about his production. I don't know who does what with any of these artists and if they produce their own beats, if they write their own lyrics, whatever. But something about songs by the Toys I am really into.
You know, like a guy that's like a big pop star? When you think of like male pop stars, like the first one I think of is like Justin Bieber. And I wonder if that's like the same for like in Thai. Like, do you think the Toys when you think this genre of music? I'm just rambling right now.
Cut that out.
Just to be Canadian, I could have stopped you like an hour ago.
Fuck! 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 What was the question?
I don't know.
Sounds like Justin Bieber.
With all of what I just said being true, I don't know that he would be popular in the USA just because, one, if you don't sing in English, you just lost a lot of people here. And that's always a bummer to me because tons of my favorite bands don't speak in English in their songs, and that's never mattered to me. I mean, music is a language of its own, and there's a lot that you can convey in your music and your singing without the audience needing to know what the lyrics specifically mean, but people, I guess it's like a familiarity thing or something, or who knows, or maybe people just don't respect of like the art form enough that if you're not speaking their language, they don't want to hear it.
What genre is he? I genuinely don't know his genre. Is it pop? Do you consider him pop? Yeah, he's a niche, I guess. I don't know. Fuck. I don't think he would be popular in the United States. I want to know how you're going to edit this, Jesus Christ.
Well, first of all, say that again. The tone was harsh. I don't think he would be popular in the United States. I don't have the
thoughts. It would be so great to see more artists like The Toys become internationally accepted. And I don't know what his demographic is, but I really hope it spreads.
Hey, life.
You're going.
Okay. J9, we go.
Hi, did you know that leaving a like on this video is a great way to ensure that we make more content like this? Every like that you leave on one of my videos tells YouTube that you enjoyed watching and that it should be recommended to new viewers. These types of analytics are what tell me the kind of content that my audience enjoys. So if you'd like to see more like this, be sure to let us know. Leave a comment with the artists that you'd like to see us react to next as well, because while I have a ton of artists that I'm excited for us to listen to, we're also open to any suggestions that show enough interest. That's all I have for you in this video, but what are your thoughts? What kind of qualities do you think an artist needs to be embraced by international acceptance and success? And if comments aren't your thing, head over to my Instagram because I love hearing from you guys. Find me on TikTok, Facebook, Spotify, and other music streaming services under Scott Kozdra, and follow Brittany on Instagram for more of this.
There's a firefly outside. That's crazy. Oh my god, it's so big. That's crazy. I've never seen a firefly. Okay.
That's all for now. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.